This is the church that my grandmother and my aunt and my uncle were christened in.
My grandmother, Lucia, was born as Lucia Haufe in Silesia in the 1920s, and she grew up there, a place called Briesnitz, which back then was still Germany, and had two children with her husband, my aunt and my uncle. And then the war started and her husband went to war, and as the war came to an end, he didn't return, and he was probably a prisoner of war, but she didn't know if he had died. She hadn't heard anything of him. So it was in 1944 that the Soviet army liberated this part of Germany, and in retribution for the war crimes that Nazi Germany had committed, there was a lot of violence which was specifically aimed at the women. And lots of people were running away at that point, escaping, but they didn't want to leave. They really didn't want to leave their home. They wanted to stay there. She lived together with her own mother, so my great-grandmother, and the two children and her sisters. So they stayed, and it was quite a grueling experience from what we know.
The absolute exhaustion of going through the walk had to be measured and experienced, and it was very different for us, and we're really aware that we weren't taking our real children with us. We're being funded by the Arts Council, we're staying in a hotel, we've got a home to go to at the end, so we could never get the full experience of what Lucia Rippel went through. But just to get the sense of longevity and what it feels like to walk that many miles a day.
Ganz langsam, weil vorne weg ging so Ochsenwagen. Hm. Ne? Und die Ochsen, die schaffen ja nicht mehr wie 10 Kilometer am Tag.
Ja.
Ne? Und dann mussten die sich, wer nichts zum Essen dabei gehabt hat, der musste hungern. Hm. Ne? Die sind nicht verpflegt worden unterwegs. Aber sie haben manchmal in Scheunen übernachtet oder auf so Bauernhöfe, die halt ein bisschen Platz gehabt haben. Und die Mutti ist dann immer, wenn sie das gemacht haben, mit mir und mit Wolfgang zum Betteln gegangen. Ne? Mhm. Und da wollte sie immer, dass dann die Schwester halt mitgeht, die Tante Grete. Und nein, nein, sie bettelt nicht, sie da lieber stirbt sie. Sie ist nicht zum Betteln gegangen, aber die Mutti musste halt gehen, hat zwei Kinder. Mhm. Die hat bloß gesagt, dass halt manche sind halt einfach sitzen geblieben. Es waren ja welche dabei, die konnten nicht so laufen. Oder wie zum Beispiel der Wolfgang, der musste die ganze Strecke laufen. Also sehr frühe Erinnerung als an Putzpforde eben, an dieses Zimmer bei den Langes. Ja, dann kann ich mich noch erinnern an das Abendessen immer. Da saßen viele Leute dort bei den Bauern Lange am Abend um den Tisch rum, und da gab es meistens Pellkartoffeln und jeder einen Löffel Öl auf den Teller und ein bisschen Salz. Und die Mutti, die musste halt, wie gesagt, den ganzen Tag auf den Feldern arbeiten, und wir Kinder, wir sind halt dort auf dem Bauernhof rumgerannt, und da hat weiter niemand nach uns geschaut am Abend halt, wenn wiederkommen ist. Ne? Panzer kommen und das ganze Dorf ist hinausgerannt. Ob das jetzt noch Amerikaner waren oder Russen, das weiß ich nicht.
Where the landscape dissolves into sky.
Where night after night our shadows touch each other with fettered wings.
Between where we are
and where we are not.
In a cursed circle of blood.
Our dreams gone and no guarantees.
Lie on the pulsing shore, battered, and beneath our fallen banners.
Powerlessness.
Guilt.
After every war, someone has to clean up. Things won't straighten themselves up, after all. Someone has to push the rubble to the side of the road so the corpse-filled wagons can pass. Someone has to get mired in scum and ashes, sofa springs, splintered glass, and bloody rags. Someone has to drag in a girder to prop up a wall. Someone has to glaze a window, rehang a door. Photogenic, it's not, and takes years. All the cameras have left for another war. We'll need the bridges back. New railway stations. Sleeves will go ragged from rolling them up. Someone, broom in hand, still recalls the way it was. Someone else listens and nods with unsevered head. But already, there are those nearby starting to mill about who will find it dull. From out of the bushes, sometimes someone still unearths rusted out arguments and carries them to the garbage pile. Those who knew what was going on here must make way for those who know little and less than little, and finally as little as nothing. In the grass that is overgrown, causes and effects, someone must be stretched out, blade of grass in his mouth.
To begin with, they were raped, the women, but then it was the Russian officer that took over the town hall, and in the evening the women had to go over, and they more or less willingly did so. Rather than being raped, they just turned up and submitted themselves, but eventually my grandmother wasn't sent anymore because she just felt pregnant the whole time. But every couple of months, the mayor of the town, he would take all the girls, the young girls who had to see the Russian officers, and take them to the next town to have an abortion. So they were all at the back of a horse and cart and went there too. So it kind of became a rape routine. And well, I think the only way for my grandmother or for many women of the time to deal with it was to just accept, well, this is just what's happening and this is what's happening to everyone, and just continue as much as they could with some kind of routine. It was in 1945 at the Potsdam Agreement that it was decided that this part of Germany was to become Poland. People were expelled from this part of Germany and it became Poland. And they weren't allowed to take many things, they had to walk. So you really could just grab your own belongings, the children's pram. My aunt was only 2 years old, so she wasn't walking very well yet. So they took the pram and then whatever they could cram into a suitcase. And they walked. They walked the whole distance of about 300 kilometers. And she was hosted by a family and they lived in the attic there with her two children.
So my grandmother, Elisabeth Kaufmann, she left Lithuania with her parents and her husband, but at the year 42. In Lithuania, they had a community which were mixed, Lithuanians and Germans, German origins. But then it was actually my grandfather who felt that it was better to leave the country. And actually, my mother says that she thinks that my grandmother was nearly excited to leave the small villages and to go to Berlin, which had that big, big fame of being a free and interesting city. And actually, when they arrived there, they were living in the east, and it was really then when the war actually happened. And of course, there was also the Russian army, and she was really beautiful. I could see that, but especially for the taste of the time. And she was really afraid of being raped. Sorry. Sorry. She did put layers of clothing over her and covered her face with ashes and grease. And she played an insane woman because they were told that the Russians don't touch insane because they are afraid of being insane too then. I once tried to speak to her about that. But she was so getting so unhappy that I felt that I have not the strength to be for her. Maybe something happened that I don't know. As a teenager, I used to make fun of her looking at all the more or less cheesy films from that time. But I can really see that they have all the right to look at cheesy stuff because they have gone through so much, which we simply can't imagine.
Something that really struck me was when we were doing the walk, we saw the news in Polish about sort of the increase, the breakout, the refugee crisis, and seeing it in a different language, but understanding what was happening and seeing the children and families in devastation. It's just about survival and humanity, which is what is so upsetting about the sort of situation, refugee crisis now, that there's pockets of humanity, but it's not a generic humanity that we should all be showing.
There was a group of refugees in Budapest that they didn't let on the trains to go to Germany, and they decided eventually, oh, we'll just walk. So there was this other group of people out of desperation, having left their homes, who then walked a much greater distance, even from Budapest to Germany. It became really clear how relevant and urgent it is today to talk about migration.
How did you feel when you got to Portsmouth?
Well, it was strange because I thought I would feel quite emotional and that it would be this climax of this journey, quite emotional, and seeing those places. It was kind of humbling. It was such a small, tiny village, a couple of streets, and nothing really spectacular. And it felt like something that made me feel taller and made me think of my grandmother, of this heroine who did this journey with her children.